Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I'm just hitching on the honey trailer here so that we can go and take a bit of honey down to the mod down there, and it's the cereal side of it. The cereal side of it has now run out of honey. The other side has still got stuff. We got a couple of pallets down there that we're going to need to empty out very soon. So if I just back in here a second and refill, there we go, the pipe jumps straight to it. I do like that. It's only like a tiny, tiny little detail, but I do really like it. Right, while that's filling, our question for this week, I am going to plant some sugar beet, and I'm hoping that we will have time to harvest said sugar beet before we switch over to FS17. So which harvester do you want me to use? Do you want me to use the tractor-mounted gear here? Do you want me to use the original self-propelled harvester? Or do you want me to use the Holmer self-propelled harvester? That's the one that we used in Melbury Estate. So it's your vote. It's your game. Head to the comment section down below and let me know which one you want. It's one of these three. You've got the topper and the trailer. They both go together on a tractor. Or you've got the self-propelled one or the new self-propelled one. Yeah, so I will hopefully be able to harvest sugar beet before we transfer over to FS17. It is going to be tight. Today we are picking up some of this grass that we've got here, and then I know I'm driving over the windrows here, but I'm sure we'll be okay with that. There we go. Right. So yeah, we are getting ever closer to FS17, and I'm hoping that we will have time to do that, a sugar beet harvest. If we don't, then, you know, we will just have to say that's a bit unfortunate, but I'm hoping that we will. Right, we'll fill the honey back up so that one can carry on. As soon as that's done, I'm going to unload the two pallets that are here and we'll drive them down to the bottom. There we go, that one's done. You know what, I could actually just leave this tractor here for now because we have got a lot that I want to get done today, because like I said, we are pressed for time. Today we are picking up grass. We've got grass in this field. It's grown really, really fast. Okay, we've had a growth stage. I did the raking up last night, and then we slept the night, so we are now the following morning and the grass has grown incredibly fast. So we've got that to deal with. Now let me see if we can pick this up. It's extremely difficult to judge it just right. Ooh, I think we've got it. There we go. Right. So we've got a part pallet of the Met, and then we've got the cereal over the other side that we want to gather up as well. And let's just come over here. So we'll take these two, and we've got a pallet of wool as well. It's a bit difficult to see because of the mixed feeder information there, but I'm pretty certain by now we will have a pallet of wool. I haven't actually checked it. So I will drive up there and we'll do that, and we'll take this trailer of the two pallets down the bottom as well. We'll sell those, gather up the grass. Then tomorrow we are doing slurry spreading. We will get the new slurry tanker that I asked you about last week, and we will spread slurry on field 3, and we'll do that before we do the seeding. And so then as soon as that is done, we'll do the seeding. Don't know if we'll have time to start that tomorrow. It might be next week that we have to start that. And then we should, and once we've done that, I think we'll do a bit of combining, because we've got a few fields ready to do combining in. We've done quite a bit of work now on the beekeeping mod, so I'm happy that we've sort of done, you know, covered most of the beekeeping mod, experienced a lot of what it's got to offer. Right, let's just take this one, and I will go up and we'll see about the pallet of wool, and then we can walk back down here in a minute and get that one and drive that down to sell that as well. We don't appear to have much wool. I couldn't see it because of the mixed feeder thing. I'm guessing that would be because we've not had any grass in for the sheep, so they've only been on 5% production instead of 100% production. Yeah. So anyway, we'll run down here and get the pickup a minute. I'm going to take the pickup via the roads this time. We're going to come round here, and I don't know if the pallets actually lock in place or not. I didn't really pay much attention to that last time, but we're going to drive up here, up to the farm. No! Okay, they don't lock, and we have a disaster. Right, It means I got to try and find a way to keep them on and then get them loaded back on. I didn't want that to happen. Well, at least the stuff has stayed on the pallets. There is that. Right, I'm going to need to pick this up because I want to pick this grass up in a minute. Let's go and get the JCB in a minute. Okay, I'll back out of here, and then we got to zoom down over there and pick up those two pallets, put them back onto that trailer, and then at a much more sedate pace, get out. I'm pretty sure that they went all right last time, didn't they? We took them both down there. They both came off, and I didn't think I went, excessively slow. I thought it seemed all right. I suppose it's quite steep there, and we did keep them fairly level last time. Now, I got to try and pull these pallets back. I wanted to do the grass today. I want to get that in for the sheep. I'm going to get it in for the sheep and take some in for the cows. I will do quite a bit of the grass off screen, I think, off camera. I'll do some today, and then I'll sort of finish it so that we can get on with our next job tomorrow. Because I would like to hurry up. Ooh, I'm going to have to do it from the lower side, I think. I can't really put this on from the other side. Let's come up here, and there's one pallet. At least we don't have to worry about the pallet of wool. There we go. There's one. Now I've got to get the next one. Right, I'll do this a sec, and then we will see about carrying it down. Because I want to get on with doing the grass. Going to go a little bit slower, and I'm hoping if I go straight up here, these pallets won't fall off. Because that was not handy. I mean, they do seem to be sticking fairly well. It might just have been because it was quite steep that caused them to just topple over. And you're never really quite sure of the physics of this game, as it's quite when things are going to go and when they're not. It does seem to sort of have a mind of its own some days. Right. Well, all seems to be going well so far. Nearly there. That went all right there, coming down the hill. We did. There was a moment where they slid ever so slightly, I think. But yeah, we did okay. Right, we're safe. So let me just go and whiz this one over here again. That one can park up there and stop. Right, you will notice that I have brought the slurry tanker up here ready to sell so that we can buy the next one. So I will sell that one quickly, but we kind of need to get the grass going today. Although, I mean, the sheep are doing all right. So let's sell that one for 5,800. Now that I think about it, the sheep are doing all right. We could actually do the slurry spreading first so that we can get going with the sowing. Because it would be good if we could actually get the sugar beet into the ground. And then we can always do the grass afterwards, sort of while the sowing is going on. That might actually be a better way to do it. So let's buy our new slurry tanker, which is in here. The Fliegl, okay, and back out. Right. And into the Sammy Fortis. Now then. I'm not sure what this tanker is going to be like. I think it's got a slightly smaller spreading width than the one we got rid of, but it's got a bigger tank. And quite a few of you did say that this is the one you wanted. And I'm kind of glad, to be honest. I thought that the Zunhammer was going to be a tad overkill for this map. And to be honest, I'm not even certain that this tractor would have been able to pull it properly. And like I said right back at the... beginning of this series. Let's just put the PTO in. I didn't want to go for anything bigger than this tractor. I wanted this tractor to be the biggest one that we've got. Because I felt that it was more realistic if we was to do it like this. A small farm like this, you wouldn't be going around with a 400 horsepower tractor. It just wouldn't happen. You would have small machinery, and yeah, that is just generally how things would have been run. So that is what we're going to do. I'll just run this back to the farm, and then we can start loading up with slurry. Now, the slurry tank is just down here, right next to the side here. So I'm hoping that if I come up beside it here like this, now does it fill from the front, or does it fill from the back? Some of these will fill from the back, some of them fill from the front. I don't think it matters for that one. But yeah, I've used tankers. I've used a couple of different types of tankers. Some of them, you just put a hose right on the back there, on the back. You take off that spreading plate and you put the hose on the back, and it sucks in through the same hole that it blows it out of. This one looks like it actually sucks stuff in from the side, on that hose there, that attachment. And also this one looks like it can be put into the top. You don't get that on all tankers. Some tankers you only get like the hole in the back that you can use. I mean, tankers come in all shapes and sizes, and I've not really used very, like I said, I've only used two, so I haven't used very many at all. And the ones that I used were fairly simple. There's just one hole on the back, and then you had a pump that would set to either suck or blow. And that was about it. That was the full extent of the options on that tanker. Right then. And I think all we got to do is just press B and it will just go. There we go. So we do have the GMK mod on here, and it is actually spreading stuff on the field. We don't have a very wide spreading width on this one. See, I was out a little bit too far to start with. Now I'm spreading into the hedge, which we don't really want to do. And I'm doing this a lot out of cab because I want to be able to see what we're doing. Zoom out any further than that? I don't think I can. Now, is it going to let me... Yeah, it's not going to let me spread onto the field that I don't own. I'm going to come up here like this. And now, tight to the hedge. I'm going to have to back up here, I think. Oh, no. We'll be all right. Just come along this way. It could take a little while to cover this field like this. I think that'll be all right. I think we'll work through this okay. And yes, I know that we do need to get on and gather that grass in. It's all raked up and the grass is now growing. But I thought if we can do this, we could get the sugar beet being sown and then go back to the grass while this is growing, or even while we're in the middle of sowing it. We can sort of leave hired help carrying on with sowing it, and we can carry on. But I thought it'd be better. We want to spread the slurry first, because then the drill will kind of incorporate that into the field a little bit. And that is coming along quite nicely. If I can zoom in a little bit and give us a better view of it. That's not a bad view. There we go. But now I can't see what I'm doing. We are going to get almost entirely right round this field in with one tanker full, which is not bad going, actually, all things considered. There we go. It's still a bit difficult to judge the exact width. It is quite narrow. It is a very narrow spread. But because of the large tank capacity, I think that's going to work out okay. And I was surprised. The tractor did okay climbing the field, to be honest, didn't it? So if we stop there. And now, this is something that you wouldn't do in real life when you're spreading slurry or anything like that. You wouldn't go right round the edge first. What you would do is... you'd start in the middle, so that you're not driving over what you've spread. Driving over what you've spread just results in a terrible, terrible mess everywhere you go. You don't want to do that. So this is not very realistic, although sometimes we've just got to sort of grin and bear it and do things that aren't overly realistic, just because it's a lot easier to figure things out with the game. And what I was hoping to... Oh, that's the end of that load. What I was hoping to do is we'll spread... a bit more up that... yeah, we'll do one more line up that side. I'll do a couple lines over that side as well. Actually, most of the way around the field, I should think. And then we can leave the hired help doing it. And I'm hoping that we could get the doits onto the... we could get the doits onto the poettinger, onto the forage wagon, and go and get a load of grass while the hired help is doing some of the slurry spreading. And I'm hoping we can do that, because that means we could kind of kill two birds with one stone. So let's back up round there. And is that close enough to fill? Yes, it is. Excellent. So we'll do a bit of this from in the cab. 2 ton, 3, 4. Right. I realise it does seem to be a bit of a slower episode. I know that we got lots to do, but I just feel like we're a bit slower today. I don't know what people think. Sometimes I really get excited about a machine, and I got to be honest, slurry spreading is not one of my favourite jobs in this game. It never has been. But then I've never been that keen on slurry spreading in real life. Always found it a bit sort of monotonous. Although I've got to say, using a rotor spreader, you know, like the barrel spreader that we've got in this game, and I was hoping to use that, I actually quite enjoy that job in real life. Using the tankers like this, that is something that never personally appealed to me very much. But using the muck spreader, you know, the side barrel muck spreader, that one I've always liked using. It requires a bit more skill to use that one, though. You don't just switch it on and drive around the field without actually really seeing very much. You switch the machine on, and you've got to keep a really close eye on how thick and fast the slurry or the manure is coming out of the barrel spreader. You know, I don't know if everybody knows which one I'm referring to. I'll quickly show you. That one there, and I'd like to try and use that one. If we got some time, I'd like to just at least do a load with that one. So it chucks it outside. Now, the way that it works, it's got chains on the inside. The bigger muck spreaders, you know, the ones that chuck them out the back. Those, the muck goes out at a set rate. It's how far you open the gate, and that's just how fast it goes out. So you don't have much, there's not much skill involved. You just turn it on and drive. But the chain spreader, there is actually quite a degree of skill involved with operating that. Oh, there we go. Because with a chain spreader, the chains aren't obviously all the way out to start with, and they're not throwing muck out fast. To start with, you only have like a little bit at the end, so you've got to drive quite slow. And you've got to keep a really close eye on the rate that the muck is being thrown out of the machine so that you can adjust your speed accordingly and make sure that you have a nice even spread on the field, because otherwise you have huge great big clumps in some areas and hardly anything on the field in other areas. So because of that reason, I've always quite enjoyed using those machines. It's just, it makes it a little more interesting. It's a bit more of a challenge rather than just sitting there and pressing the on button and driving in a straight line. And that's sort of always been the way with me. The machines that require more skill to operate is the ones that I've always enjoyed using, whereas the ones that you literally just go and, like cultivating, for example. Cultivating, once you've driven round the field the first time and sort of seen anything interesting that there might be to see in the field, cultivating after that gets extremely dull. And I mean extremely dull. It is a very, very boring job. A bit like rolling as well. After you've, once you've sown the field, cultivated the field, and then you sow it. Normally you roll the field after that. We don't have that in this game, but you roll it flat. This kind of squashes the earth down flat. There's different types of rollers that you use, but essentially what you're doing is you're just tamping it down tight so it presses against the seed and causes better contact with the ground, which ultimately gives better results with your planting and your growth and your harvest and so on. Right, if I come up here, that should be about right for using the hired help. So I'm just pressing H now, and the hired help is going to go. Hopefully he will do a grand job. So he's going to go along. We'll wait until this one's finished, and then we'll go and refill him. And then I'll see if we can get the doits onto the forage wagon so we can go and get some grass. There's just enough room to spin round, although because the hired help does tend to turn quite sharp, it's a little unrealistic on that first initial turn, but we can live with that. It's not going to be the end of the world, I don't think. I do like the GMK mod, and it seems to operate differently in different places, on different maps, and like the graphics of it are slightly different. But this one, the lime didn't show up as well as it does in hard working. But obviously, the lime I thought in hard working was a little bit excessive. It looked like it snowed. So this might be a little better. The slurry and the two of them, they seem quite similar, and I quite like it. I quite like this the effect, the slurry on this. So I'm just going to fill this one up, and then we'll see about getting that. I'll fill this one and get it going. We've already seen me do this once. And then I'll get going with that Deutz over there. We'll get that set up with the forage wagon. Before I get going with this one, I'm just going to hose it off, because it is absolutely filthy. Cultivating does cover these machines in dust and dirt quite a lot. We've got our hired help going up in the field. He's doing quite well. And we've got the, I don't know what that one's called, you know, this mod on the side there with the green writing there that's showing us what we've got in the machines. Still not changing though. Oh, no, there he goes. He's turned around and he's going back the other way now. So we can use that to monitor. That would be the same as me having a PDA or maybe even on my phone, an app like that that's just showing me what's going on with all the machinery on the farm. And you can actually get that now. Obviously, you probably wouldn't have it on a small farm like this, but there is things like that that you can use these days to monitor everything that is happening on your farm with every machine that you've got. Now, let's just back this one in here, and then we will go and find the forage wagon and get us a load of grass. Put that in there, lower it down, and unhitch. Right, I'll get the forage wagon hitched on, and we can go and find some grass to pick up. We're not going to have time for very much more, so we'll be able to pick up one load of grass, I should think. We're going to do this field up here because I didn't actually do any of this on camera when I was doing the raking. Did it all off camera. So I'll do this one first. We'll get one load and probably just put it in for the sheep. Actually, no, we'll put it in for the cattle. We will take it back down and we'll put it in for the cattle. So they've got a little bit of grass to carry on with. I will finish the muck spreading before tomorrow's episode. And that means that we can get started on drilling the sugar beet. Now, we can use just the standard drill, but I have heard that we might be able to use a very special drill. And this one is actually pretty cool. I would like to try it out. I've tested it just to make sure there's no major bugs. It's not going to crash the game. I don't think it will. I'm hoping it won't, and I'm hoping that we can actually use this thing. It is not really what we would use on a map of this size. It you know, this is kind of more of a big farm machine. However, it is that awesome, and I'm not really going to be able to use it on Sandy Bay. So I figured I would use it on this one just so that we can try it before we move over to FS17. Because, quite frankly, this thing does look cool. It would be a shame not to at least have one go with it. You'll see what I mean when you see it tomorrow. I'm not going to tell you what it is now. That would spoil the surprise. But just know that there is something pretty epic on its way for tomorrow's episode when it comes to doing the drilling the sugar beet. Now, if I come down here, I'm hoping if I spin round, I get a bit more up this way. I was hoping that those couple of little bits up there would be enough to fill this trailer up, and then we can run it back down to the cattle. The slurry tanker is empty. Although, actually, it might not be empty. It might have just reached the point in the field where we need to sort of start from the other side. Could be. We'll have to see. I'll see when I get back down there. This grass seems to have grown obscenely fast. I don't remember it growing this fast, because we only cut it yesterday. And it wasn't like I'm going to miss a big chunk there. That's right, we're at 75%. Yeah, it just seems to have grown really, really fast. I'm not sure if it's something to do, because I know there's chunks here that can't be cut. And someone did tell me, I nearly went off the edge there, I've got to be careful of that. Someone did tell me that the Sosnovka map does the same. There's big chunks on there that you can't actually mow, which is slightly annoying. And I could imagine that would be slightly annoying. I'm not quite sure why they've released the map on... I mean, I can understand on this one, because it kind of looks like this area here wasn't intended for game use. So I don't know if there's something special about the map that stops you from being able to mow it physically. I really don't. I don't know very much about map making. I just know when I see an awesome one. But I'm not quite sure why Giants would be releasing a map that doesn't let you mow in chunks. That's one of those little mysteries. If anybody does know the answer to that little mystery of life, then please let me know. I would love to find out. Right, that's probably enough from here. I am going to run out of time. We've got 87% in here, which is 18,500. Put that in for the cattle down there. That should be enough to just make up another round of mixed feed. I might have to take the JCB down and put in another spoonful of silage. I'll have it. We'll see. Once we put this in, it'll soon tell us if we've not got enough silage in there to make up the next load of feed from the robotic mixer. And by the way, that robotic mixer is awesome. I really do like it. I watched it the other day. It was off camera, but I did just kind of watch it very quickly while it did its little round. And there are actually machines in the world that do that. You do actually have robotic feeders like that mix it all up and then take it out and put it in for the cattle. And they are really cool. It is such a brilliant invention. Let's come up here. And back up. I know it allows you to tip when you're further out, but it just doesn't feel right. Doesn't actually feel right tipping it straight from the trailer into this, but that bit I'll live with. There we go. Right, is it still going to say fill level too low, or is it going to let me... going to accept it now. Still saying it's too low. Can you not see that I've put grass in there now? Look, there's loads of it. There should be more than enough to keep you happy. Must start in a minute. I don't know if you've actually got to press a button. I don't think... No. Oh, there we go. See, it's going to go and fill up now. Right, I will take this back up, and I will get another load of grass, and then tomorrow's episode, we will tip this load of grass, and I will also finish doing the slurry spreading. We've done a bit of slurry spreading today. We've seen it in action, so I'll finish that one off, and I'll get a load of grass here ready, and then we can have a look tomorrow at this really cool cedar that I want to show you. I think this thing is spectacular. I think you are going to like it. So... my question for this week is, which of the three sugar beet harvesters do you want me to use? The tractor mounted one, the original self-propelled one, or the new self-propelled one? Head into the comment section down below and let me know your choice. It is your vote, it's your game. Now, if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch me as well, that would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar, goodbye, and see you later.